Hi, my name is Dr. Stephanie Crewe. I'm Chief of Adolescent Medicine here at Children's Hospital of Richmond at VCU. So this is a very, very exciting time. I think that we have seen the devastation of the natural course of COVID-19. We have lost a lot. We've lost some of our freedoms. We've lost family, we've lost friends, I've even lost patients. And so this is a critical time for us to be very much aware that we have somewhat of an answer to the question of when will this be over? For me, the COVID-19 vaccine represents a critical opportunity for us to heal and for us to get to our new normal, not only as family and friends, but as community and also as a nation. Absolutely, the COVID vaccine has been proven to be safe and effective. Right now, there are ongoing clinical trials that are being tested actually below the age of 16 years of age. Right now, there is emergency approval for those that are 16 and older for the Pfizer vaccine. That has been shown to be safe and effective. And I presume that shortly we will find that we are giving this vaccine to kids even younger as more safety and efficacy trials are being done currently. The anticipated side effects are like various vaccines that we already receive. So pain and swelling at the site of the injection are two of the most common side effects with this vaccine. Oftentimes also there may be a little bit of fatigue, some mild headaches, and some muscle aches. So those are generally the side effects that we see with this vaccine that are very similar to other vaccines that we are very used to getting. There have been countless studies that have addressed this specific concern regarding fertility and future fertility, and there has been no scientific evidence that that is the case. There has been no evidence to support that there is any effect or impact on future fertility of either females or males. So that has been continuously disproven as a theory. Before I actually tell them anything, I actually have to do an inner search. And one of the things that I typically do would just be to acknowledge that vaccine hesitancy is real and it comes from a specific place within each individual. And so I have to acknowledge the history of vaccinations in this country. I have to acknowledge the impact that this has on families and their children. I also have to acknowledge that vaccine hesitancy is a normal response for something that is very new. The second thing that I have to do is empathize with families that are very fearful and very conscious about what they're doing and giving to their children. And then after I acknowledge and I really empathize with those families, that gives me the ability to help to educate, helps to answer questions, helps to address fears, helps to highlight benefits of the vaccines. But it's only through that lens that I'm able to deliver appropriate guidance for patients and their families regarding not only the COVID-19 vaccine, but vaccines in general. Yes, so I did get the COVID vaccine. There was a pause in me getting the vaccine because I too needed to learn some things. I needed to relearn some things and I needed to unlearn some things in terms of what the vaccine was about, how it would affect my own health, how it would affect my patients. So I really needed to go to a place of education. And for me, that took more than several weeks after the vaccine, after I was eligible to take the vaccine. So I did go through my own period of vaccine hesitancy, but I think during that time, I used it to educate myself. I also used it as a time to optimize preventive strategies for myself. And again, I used it as an opportunity to hone in what was stopping me from preventing me from getting the vaccine. I had to really take an inner look at that. But yes, I did get the COVID vaccine. We are doing a soft launch this week with the Pfizer vaccine, which has been authorized for emergency use for those that meet the phase 1B criteria over the age of 16. So this is a prioritized age group and a prioritized group of vulnerable youth that would meet that criteria. And CHORE will be rolling that out for patients of the CHORE family. So we are redefining what normal is. Normal is not what it was in the past, but we are creating a new normal. There will be a lifting of some restrictions after teens are fully vaccinated, but we will still expect that there would be facial coverings, that they will still maintain social distancing, that they would be aggressive in hand washing, and that they would, you know, continue to remain in small groups. This is nothing like what we've previously experienced in our lives in terms of normal, but we will gradually be creating a new normal for not only teens, but adults as well. There are several ways in which information is being generated, and so I want to give you some key resources for here in Richmond and to our CHORE family. Number one is the Virginia Department of Health has excellent information about COVID-19, the COVID-19 vaccines, questions about enrollment and how to enroll. So that's the first place I would go, Virginia Department of Health. The second is ourselves. We have a website, chrichmond.org is the name of that website, which has critical information, particularly for enrolling in the vaccine, as well as questions regarding the vaccine, including frequently asked questions about the vaccine. We also would advise cdc.gov has great information on COVID-19 in general and COVID-19 vaccine as well. So those are the top three I would say we would strongly advocate for you to take a look at all of those websites. Contact us if you have any questions or concerns regarding any of the information that is on that website or on those websites.